Welcome to the mango episode of Simi's Kitchen Diaries. It's mangoes all over the world, especially in India. Umpteen number of dishes pop up in different styles with baby mangoes to the ripe ones. Sauces, curries, desserts, preserves, juice, list is endless. Mango murabba is a preserve which is made right across India in different forms. Murabba is nothing but a fruit preserve which is made all over the world and which we Indians call as murabba. Today I am preparing raw mango murabba which is widely made in northern part of India. Simple yet a delightful fruit preserve which can be stored till the next summer. So guys, without delay, let's look at the ingredients needed for this murabba and then get on to the cooking part. Raw mangoes are used for this, but usually I take raw mangoes which are slightly yellow in color. This is a bit more, but it is very sour. This should be in the medium level stage where the nut is slightly hard but not completely grown or firm. I have cut into large chunks the mangoes and I have taken 1 kg of mangoes here. The skin should be peeled thoroughly and no green part should be there. If the green part is there, it will turn sour and the taste will become bitter. The next item is jaggery syrup or the molasses syrup. I have melted and made it in a loose consistency because as we boil it, that will become caramelized. Now, there are some people who use only jaggery. I am using brown sugar and jaggery. Jaggery quarter that of the brown sugar. Next is vinegar, which will give some extra sourness and help in balancing the flavor. Few strands of saffron, crushed cloves, 4 pieces, 1/2 teaspoon red chili powder, 2 tablespoons of ginger julienne and 1 green chili or red chili, which is spicy in nature, and 1 inch cinnamon, 4 pieces, crushed roughly. So these are the ingredients which goes into making this murabba, and let's move on to the cooking part now. I've taken heavy bottomed steel pan here because this will help in maintaining the temperature and also the texture of the murabba. Into this goes 500 grams of raw sugar along with 1.5 cups of water. To this I'm going to add 1 cup of jaggery concentrate or the molasses syrup. Now it's turn of the vinegar. 6 tablespoons of vinegar I've added into this. I actually added 2 tablespoons in the beginning and then later check the taste and add accordingly to your preference. I took around 6 tablespoons of vinegar into this. Now the ginger julienne. Now we'll mix this up and allow it to boil until the flavor of ginger is completely blended into the syrup and syrup is slightly thick in texture. Adjust and keep adding vinegar as you go through the process. Keep stirring often until all the sugar is melted and the mixture starts to boil. Now I have added this ginger into the sugar molasses mixture so that we get a candy type of ginger when the murabba is finally done. So the syrup has started boiling, as you can see here. It is slightly thicker in texture. I'm mixing it up thoroughly so that the ginger flavor gets well blended into the syrup. The mixture is ready now. When it is slightly thick, we'll add the mangoes into this and allow the mangoes to cook well but firm and soft. Now you can keep the pot open or you can stick a lid on and cook it, but be careful to check in between so that the mangoes don't mash up by overcooking. Usually what I do is once it starts to boil, I keep the lid on for around 5 to 6 minutes. So I have mixed up the mangoes now and to this I'm adding the split chili. Now we'll allow this to boil. Keep mixing as often as possible so that everything is well blended and the mixture is thoroughly homogenized. Now I am going to stick the lid on and cook this for 5 to 7 minutes until the mangoes are just done. Should be cooked inside but firm and soft. Now the mangoes will start releasing its moisture content. So first you will see that the syrup will loosen a bit, but as you go along it will start to thicken and you will get the right texture. So it has been cooking for 5 to 7 minutes. I have taken out the lid. As you can see here, the mangoes are cooked well, soft but firm. The slow cooking process allows to get the murabba the right texture. Now at this point, I'm going to add the chili powder and the crushed spices. Give a quick mix and allow it to cook further by letting it simmer. Keep stirring often until the sugar syrup starts to thicken and glazy texture comes on the mangoes. Keep on medium low flame. It should not be burnt or caramelized. As you can see here, the murabba has started to thicken. The sugar syrup is getting thick and gorgeous. The mangoes are looking awesome. At this stage, we'll add the saffron soaked in water. Mix up once again and we'll let it simmer for another 5 to 6 minutes so that the water content from the saffron also gets dried up and syrupy. So the murabba is getting ready. You can see here the mangoes have popped up and the sugar syrup is getting reduced. With all the spices, I can smell the tanginess of the mangoes and the flavors of the spices and ginger in the kitchen. Now adding 2 pinches of salt to get that complete balance for this murabba. Mix up once more and simmer for couple of minutes and you are ready to go. Now sterilize the jars in advance, dry it out, and once the murabba is cooled well, you can transfer it and store it in airtight containers. This will remain for 1 year without getting spoiled. So you can preserve your mangoes during this mango season in the form of murabba, squashes or preserves or jams and jellies. You can even freeze it out so that you can use it later. I hope you all will try this out and get back to me with all your comments and feedback. See you soon with another episode. Take care and bye bye.